everything you did up. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, and on the ground, no matter where I go, I don't need to worry now that I know. Everything I need you got. There's honey in the rock, purpose in your plan, power in the blood, healing in your hand. Started flowing when you said it is done. Everything you did enough. Looking, I keep finding, I keep giving, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep proving. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep looking, I keep finding.
Church. Please put your phones on silent and listen to all these awesome things we have going on here. Every Sunday, we pray for God to move in our services. Join us at 8:15 in the hospitality room or downstairs at 10. Remember that prayer moves the hand of God. Are you visiting RLC? Come to the hospitality room after church and meet our pastors. They'd love to see you. Our Life Connection class is every Sunday downstairs at 10:30 to 11:30. Taught by Claude Wright. Everyone is welcome.
Food pantry distribution is this Tuesday night. Volunteers, please be here by 4:15. Let's feed our community.
Remember your 12 weeks rooted in Christ assignment. Today begins our 11th week, which is posted in the bulletin and on our website. Radiant Life Church is launching an outreach mission called Buckets of Hope. This is to help all those affected by Hurricane Helene. There's a list of items located on the information center out in the foyer, so please stop by and help us out. We need all items turned in by Sunday, December 8th. For any more questions, see Bev Halsey or Julie Skaggs. Children of Destiny and Radiant Life Church are now partnering with Fitness Now and Shop with a Cop for a turkey trot. Stop by the info center in the foyer to find out how to sign up. All proceeds are going towards Jeffco's Shop with a Cop.
RLC Kids is for ages 4 through 6th grade and is held at the Cave Youth Center at 8:45 and 10:30 every Sunday. Parents, it's important to bring your children to Kids Church so they can learn about God and interact with children their age. Connect with us online. Check out our Facebook at RLC Festus, our YouTube at Radiant Life Church Festus, our Instagram at RL_church, and our website at RadiantLifeChurch.me. Announcements are over, so church can begin.
Good morning. How many want to be rooted to grow deep and live strong? How many know that that is our theme for this year? We hope that you are participating in the study that we have in our bulletins. We want to say welcome to all of you that are here this morning. A special welcome to those of you that are watching online. We are glad that you are here. If you are visiting Radiant Life Church for the very first time, we say welcome. We would love to meet you after service. We invite you to go through the double doors, make an immediate left into our hospitality room. We would love to shake your hand and give you a small gift for visiting with us this morning. We have a few announcements. We want to make sure that we continue to remember the families that have lost loved ones last week. We have the funeral service for Wayne Hergenroder. That service will be tomorrow. It's going to be at the Mann's Funeral Home here in Festus. Visitation will be from 10 to 12 noon, and the service will be immediately following at noon. And again, that is for Wayne. We want to remember to keep Jeannie and all of the family in our prayers. Also, the funeral service for Scott Keeney, that's going to be on Saturday. It's going to be right here at Radiant Life Church. Visitation will be from 10 to 12, and again, the service will follow immediately at 12 noon. We want to love on these families, and a lot of the way that you can help us do that is we provide meals and food for these families for their for the funeral services. If you can help with either one of these services, would you please see either Debbie Covey or Brenda Holland? They will be out at the information service center right after service. So if you can help us out, we sure do appreciate it. Well, this morning I'm going to invite our ushers forward. We're going to receive our morning tithe and offering. If you would, let's stand so that we can pray over our offering. How many believe God has been good to you? Amen. Amen. And we want to make sure that we are giving back to him what is rightfully his. He only asks for 10% and he leaves us the 90. How many can say thank you, Lord? All right, let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence that I have already felt this morning. God, we thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy, your goodness, your faithfulness. God, we just ask this morning that you bless this offering. Lord, you know every need that it's going forward to accomplish. So, God, we just thank you for that. We ask a special blessing upon those that can give and those that cannot. And we ask this in your name. And everyone said, amen. Amen. You can bring your offering forward at this time.
The night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. I've tried with all my might, I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. Just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone. You picked me up, you turned me around, you placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because you heal my heart, you change my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
I cannot deny what I've seen. I got no choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So long to my old friends, like burden and bitterness. You just keep on moving. No, you ain't welcome here.
down till I walk streets of gold. I sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back home. You picked me up, you turned me around, you placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because you healed my heart, you changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
I cannot deny what I've seen. No choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So long to my old friends, like burden and bitterness. You just keep moving, knowing welcome here.
From now till I walk streets of gold, I sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back home. You picked me up, you turned me around, you placed my feet on the side of the ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because you healed my heart, you changed my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
Never lost another one. I am free, I am free, I am free. Never lost another one. I am free, I am free, I am free. Never lost another one.
I thank the Savior, because you heal my heart, you change my name. Forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Aren't you thankful for all that our God has done? Hallelujah. I'm so thankful that no matter what season I'm walking through, that He is right beside me. Hallelujah. And that He is the God of all of my days. Hallelujah.
I came to you with my heart to pieces. Found the God healing in. Turn to you, put everything behind me. Found the God who makes all things new. I look to you, drowning in my questions. Found the God who holds all wisdom. I trust in you. Stepped out on the ocean. You caught my hand upon the waves. You're the God of all my days.
Each step I take, you make the way. I will give you all my praise. My seasons change. You're the God of all my days.
Church, lift your hands this morning. Hallelujah, Lord. We're so thankful, God, for all that you have done in our lives. And God, we've come to praise you and magnify and lift you up today. Hallelujah. We know that worship is our weapon against the enemy. And God, we lift you up and magnify and extol you this morning. Hallelujah.
Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet. Savior are, that is the truth. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him high in Joseph's tomb. He answered, sealed by heaven's storm. Highest spirit in all the world.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise His name forevermore. For in this place we will see Your praise. Oh, Lord.
At break of dawn, the Son of Heaven rose again. Oh, trampled death, where is Your sting? The angels roar for Christ the King.
Oh, praise the name of the Lord.
Give Him praise up in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Oh, my, 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 my. How many knows that God is?
Mambo di alto ro, sondo di alto.
Yet I say unto my children this day, lift up my name. For it is in that name that you have eternal life. It is in that name that you're able to do what I have sent you to do and prosper. And yet I would say unto you that even as I go forward and even as you give me praise, I have the power to change the atmosphere of all that need that atmosphere changed. For the enemy has planned one thing, yet I, the Lord, have declared another. The enemy has spoken things over different ones, and yet I say unto you that I have the power to change all things, even where they are and where they will go. For I, the Lord, will move among you, and you will see my mighty hand, and you have already noticed, and you have already seen, and you have already been a part of that which I have the power to do. For I say unto you that as you call upon the name of the Lord your God and trust in me, I will not only give you the desires of your heart, but I will go far beyond that, and I will call victory to come unto them where victory is needed, saith God. Come on, somebody, give him praise up in this house. Hallelujah. 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 You know, I'm going to ask for our elders to come forward and ministers to come forward. I feel this in my spirit. Usually I was going to save it for the end of the service. I'm not going to do that. I feel like we need to move into what the Lord is doing even now. There are those that need a touch from God, and they need nothing less than a miracle. I know that for a fact. And someone had shared with me about even a baby today that God needs to undertake in, and he can. He has the power to change all things. Doctors have already stated one thing, but God has the power to change it into something totally different. And I'm believing that today. I'm believing that today for that child. If you're here today and you desire a miracle from the one who still gives miracles, and you believe that he has the power to do so, I want you to step out from where you are, whether it's for you or someone that you're going to stand in for. I want you to step out from where you are and come forward today. I'm believing that the Lord is going to do the miraculous in this service today. I think he already has. We just haven't seen it yet. Amen. But come forward. They're going to anoint you with oil. We're going to pray the prayer of faith, and the recovery is yours in Jesus' name. Amen. Come ahead. Come ahead. Anyone that has a need or knows someone that needs a touch, come forward as we pray. How many has a need today by the uplifted hand? All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, you already know before we ask. God, you knew before we entered into your house today the needs that were going to be here. And Lord, I thank you because, Lord, we shall prevail. And Lord, I believe you've already spoken a word over each and every one of us and over the thing, God, that we need the most. Lord, you have the power to change it all. Lord, I pray today, God, do the miraculous. Show your mighty works. Move by your mighty hand. Lord, change things up. God, turn around the thing that the enemy has meant for bad, and God, make great things out of it. Lord, I thank you because I believe, Lord, that it is what you desire to do in the hearts and the lives of all of these that we are praying for today. God, reach in and touch this baby that the doctors have prevailed bad over, but God, you have changed it because in your own timing, you will prevail good. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for desires of our heart. God, remove cancers, remove diseases, remove the symptoms that are causing the issues, whatever they are. God, even if they've been misrepresented by doctors, God, I pray, Lord, that you know exactly what we have need of. Touch from the top of our head to the sole of our feet. Lord, go beyond the four walls of this building, those that are watching today. Lord, you know the needs that they have. You know the things that they desire. Lord, do a work in their heart, their lives, their homes, their finance. God, move in every situation, I pray, in the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord, God, prevail today. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, your name, your name.
Break every stronghold.
Break the stronghold, Lamb of God. Break the stronghold, Lamb of God. Hallelujah. blessed be your wonderful name. Jesus.
Over fear and all anxiety.
Hallelujah.
To every soul held captive by depression, I speak Jesus.
Oh, I speak Jesus.
Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name.
Raise your hands up all over the house and just love him today. Will you do it? Just love the Lord. Thank him for what he has done. Thank him for replacing the old with the new and giving a touch that only he has the power to give. Bless his holy, holy, wonderful name. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus for replacing the old with the new. God, we praise you. We magnify your name, Lord. Thank you for your divine touch. Thank you for your divine touch, Lamb of God. Lord, we worship you today. We worship you today. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Give him a hand clap of praise in this building today. Come on. Give it up for the Lord today. Bless your wonderful, wonderful name, Lamb of God. Bless your wonderful name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Amen, amen, amen. Obey the Lord today.
Am I not a God that's more than enough? Am I not a God that's more than enough? Is there anything too hard for the Lord your God? Nay, says the Lord. Nay, says the Lord. No, 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 there is nothing too hard for me. Yet did not I raise Lazarus from the dead? Did not I walk on the water and speak to the storms of the seas? Yea, I am God, and I'm all powerful.
Oh, come on. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
One year ago, I had a tennis ball-sized brain tumor. They said it would be impossible for me to walk, to talk, and to sing again. Do you see what I'm doing? Did you hear what I sang? The God of all my days, every step that I take. And I said, you know what? They were right. It is impossible. And I stand upon that today because they just left out the space between the M and the P. I'm possible because my Bible said in Philippians 4:13, that all things are possible through Christ who strengthens you and me. Amen?
Yeah. Amen. Come on, give him praise up in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, church, give it up for the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we praise you. We worship you. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, sing it again.
Shout Jesus from the mountain, Jesus in the street.
Come on.
Jesus in the darkness of every enemy.
Oh, yes.
Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name.
Yes.
Jesus. From the mountains.
Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name.
Come on, give him praise one more time, one more time. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Lord, we give you praise up in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your wonderful, wonderful name. Oh, yeah. Blessed be your name, Lamb of God. Blessed be your name. Amen, amen, amen. One more time, put your hands together. Amen for Sister Teresa, our musicians, our worship team. What an awesome job today. Amen. Great testimony, great word, great song. Amen. To him be all praise, glory, and honor. Amen. If you have your Bibles, remain standing. Turn with us today to Psalm 37, verse number 4. Psalm 37, verse number 4. I love every bit of what I'm about to read to you, and there's so much to be looked at and given, man, just in this one scripture alone. Psalm 37, verse number 4, it says, "Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart." I'm going to read that again. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. That's good all by itself. Amen. Amen. Before you're seated, turn and look at somebody and say, "I sure am glad you're here today." Amen. 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 Good to see you, George. Amen. You may be seated if you'd like to be. Amen. Good to have everybody in the Lord's house. Good to have you here. We want to remember all of our great hunters that are out there and after Bambi. And just remember them in your prayers that the Lord will watch over. I don't know which one, Bambi or them, but let's pray for everybody involved. All right. And I know we got those that hunt. We got some that think they're hunters and some that, well, anyway, let's go on. Amen. But Psalm 37, verse number 4. Notice what it says. It says delight. Man, that in itself is a series by itself, the word delight. Delight means so, so much in the Word of God. And I encourage you to look at that quite a bit this upcoming week. That's your weekly assignment, all right? Because we're going to get into that a little bit later on, just not today. Delight. There's a lot to be said about that one word. There's a lot to be said about what it is speaking into our lives and what the Lord meant by it when David penned these words, and especially when he said, "Delight thyself also in the Lord." How many knows that a lot of us, and I said I'm not going to speak on it, but maybe I am. How many of you out there know that, again, you can delight yourself in a lot of stuff? I mean, really, you can, really can. You can delight yourself in a whole lot of stuff. Man, I give you a list of my own. And yet, here David is penning these words. He said, well, but if you do anything, delight yourself in the Lord, all right? Delight yourself in him. And then he goes on to say, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. To desire means, man, a ton. There's a lot to be said about that word, all right? Desires. Now, to desire is to long for. It is to exhibit or to feel desire for, to express a wish for, or to request they desire. In other words, like they desire an immediate answer, all right? So it is to request for something. The noun for that is to have a conscious impulse towards something or someone that promises enjoyment or satisfaction in its attainment. Not just in the thinking about it, not just in the hoping for it, not just in the dreaming of it, but in actually obtaining it and taking it with you and it being for you. It goes on to say that again, that a longing, it's a longing or a craving. Have you ever craved anything? Three of us, praise God. Have you ever craved anything? Come on, be honest. God already knows your heart. Like a, maybe like, you know, a hot fudge sundae. A big massive cinnamon roll with extra icing, lots of butter. Amen. Cup of coffee or a glass of milk to drink it down with. All right. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Have you ever really craved for something? You ever really desire something? It goes on to say something longed for or hoped for, something, again, desired. Desire, it's interesting because it's interesting to see how the current events of even our world and time have decided the key to happiness and contentment is found in obtaining every desire, in expecting instant gratification, in relentlessly pursuing our own interest at any cost. In other words, everybody owes me, everybody should give to me, and I should be able to desire everything that I want or get way ahead of what you desire, what you want and get. Everybody owes me. How many knows, again, nobody owes anybody anything? Now, you might owe your banker for your house, your car, amen, or whatever you came in on. Maybe you rode a mule today, for all I know, but you may owe the banker for the mule. The bottom line is we're living in a world where people feel like that everybody owes them something. But I'm glad to know today that, again, that God doesn't owe us anything, and yet at the same time, he ends up telling David, pen these words, I want them to delight in the Lord, but I want them to know that, again, I have the desire to give them the desires of their heart. I, as the Lord, I desire to give them their desire of their heart. And whether you want to be honest or not, you have a list of desires. You have a bucket list of things that you would like to have, like to be involved in, or that you want. And again, we're going to look at that for just a little bit this morning. And you know what? Desires are not a bad thing. I've heard people, matter of fact, I've heard a lot of people say, well, desire, if you desire too much, that's a sin. You're not going to find it in his word. He wants to give you the desires of your heart. It's when we get to a point in a place that basically those desires become a god to us. Yeah. That's when it becomes sin. When those desires take or try to take his place, then it's wrong. But when the Lord ends up touching our lives, moving and ministering into us and through us, amen. Again, he understands your desire. And isn't it interesting? Because you can get five people out of a household, if there is that many, or two people even in a household, and you can talk to them and their desires will be totally different. One will desire one thing, somebody else will desire something else. And the desire, just because they're opposite of one another, doesn't mean that household isn't actually joined together in love and unity. That ain't got anything to do with anything. The bottom line is God knows the makeup of yourself, if you will. God knows who you are, who he created you to be, and what he wants you to become. And so therefore, often we get this idea that the desires that we have, the desires that are just sort of burning within us, is something that we came up with, when really down deep, God knows where he's taking you. And how many knows that he can birth some desires in you that was never there before? But all of a sudden, he will place something in your heart, in your spirit, in your soul, and it'll seem like, man, just overnight, all of a sudden, you start craving that thing like there was nothing better. Yeah. Are you hearing me? Yeah. And when it starts happening, that's the handiwork of your God. Because when he gives you the desires, when he gives you something and he places it out there and he begins to show you some of the things that he's wanting to do in your life, he can place such a desire in you that you won't take no for an answer. How many knows we got too many people, too many children of God that's taking no for an answer nowadays? And instead of believing and trusting in his word, instead of trusting on who he is, instead of still reaching out, even when it seems like it's going the opposite direction, you still need to trust in him anyway. Amen. He can give. He said it himself. I'll give you the desires of your heart. Sometimes I wonder, though, how bad do you really want it? How bad do you really want it? So it's interesting to see how the world looks at it. I'm going to say that again. It's interesting to see how the current events of our world and time have decided that the key to happiness and contentment is found in obtaining every desire, in expecting instant gratification, which everybody wants, seems like, in relentlessly pursuing our own interest at any cost. Man, that's the world today. I don't care how you slice it and dice it. But you see, it takes a devoted disciple of Jesus to hear and respond with the lifestyle that Jesus has called us to pursue. How many believe that God has called you to pursue a certain lifestyle? Amen. We got people that pursue different lifestyles. Everybody in here is a little bit different. And there's times I've got this. I can dress up like a Philadelphia lawyer. I can, man. I've got the stuff to do it. All right, and I can dress up like a Philadelphia lawyer, but I also have clothes that I can look like the biggest hillbilly that ever hit the times. And to be quite frank with you, I am more comfortable in the hillbilly attire than I am the Philadelphia lawyer attire. All right? I can look the part, but sometimes I can be honest with you, sometimes I don't always feel the part. And if I talk, it will take away all imagination. All right? I butcher the English language. I had so many language classes, and I had so many English teachers that quit and went into other professions. Hallelujah. And no matter what I pursued or what I did, I still came out with the way that I came out. And yet at the same time, while I was in school, couldn't stand school. When I got out of school, I ended up doing more schooling than I ever did in my whole life. Sometimes I think that's when Paul said, when I would do good, I do bad. And when I would do bad, I do good. I make no sense to myself. Paul said that. I didn't. But I live by the oath that he said. And often when we end up looking over our lives, there are things that God places within us and things that we begin to pursue and a lifestyle that we begin to desire. And it's not just because that lifestyle is something that we've always sort of made up on our own. It's something that God has birthed in you because of not where you are, but where you're going. You see, God has a plan for your life even when you haven't planned out your life. God has a desire for you even when you don't realize what that desire really is. That's why he said, and that's why he has spoke over us. Matter of fact, 3 years ago, he made this statement. We even ministered along that lines about 10 things that the Lord was getting ready to do for Radiant Life Church. And one of those things was he said, I'm going to send opportunities back around to you that you missed the first time. Don't make the mistake of missing it again. I've heard people say, well, that was something I wish I would have done, but I guess that opportunity is lost. Anybody ever hear of lost opportunities? Oh, I had. That's all I've heard about opportunities is how lost they are. And yet the Lord, through tongue and interpretation, said, no, I'm getting ready to do a supernatural thing, even to the people in the lives that are in this church. I'm going to send back around to you the opportunities that you did lose, but I'm going to give you a second chance. And this time, will you not know it? How many of you out there knows that God can do a new thing? He can change your atmosphere. He can change where you're headed. He can change your view of things. He can change your heart and your burden that you have. And man, when he does, get ready because it's going to be a supernatural thing when he does it. You see, it's one thing for me to view you in a certain way. It's another how you view yourself. Because most of us, and I've said this for the last 3 Sundays in a row, here comes number 4, most of us have the power, we feel like, to forgive everybody about everything to the most, And yet at the same time, we're not willing to forgive ourselves about hardly anything. And the enemy puts you in that place because he knows as long as he can con you into believing you'll never match up, you'll never go forward in the things of God. Let me tell you something. You're better than that. Look at your neighbor and say, you're better than that. Oh, yes, you are. Not because of who you are, but because of who he made you to be. Are you hearing me? And as he looks at all of us, he says, hey, I want to give you the desires of your heart. The problem is many children of God have stopped having desires. Many of us have stopped dreaming. Many of us have stopped pursuing. Many of us have stopped trying remotely to go after what he said was already ours. And yet God has a way of reminding us, hey, regardless of what you think you ought to go get, if I have to, I can drive it right up to your front door. And let me tell you something. Somebody says, oh, well, he won't do that. Oh, yeah, he will. He has done it in the past, and he can do it now. Notice this, if you will. It takes a devoted disciple of Jesus to hear and respond with the lifestyle that Jesus has called us to pursue, even to the point that we got to realize that, again, we have been teaching. That's why we've been teaching on discipleship. That's why we've been talking about rooted, grow deep, live strong. In order to become the disciple that God has commissioned you to be, you've got to realize something. That is, and with even that being said, discipleship demands even restraint on your part. Somebody said, well, wait a minute, preacher. Do you want us to go after it or do you want us not to go after it? How many knows that, again, restraint is not always a bad thing? Okay? I didn't say we like it, but restraint is not always a bad thing. Sometimes we have to restrain ourselves from wanting foolish things and dreaming too small. Come on, somebody. And believing or not believing. And we got to get back to a place where we understand God wants us to take back control over our lives. See, most people in this house today, whether you want to admit it or not, there's a lot more people that have control over you and that you've given them control over you than God ever intended for them to have control over you. And that being said, if somebody else is calling the shots in your life, if somebody else is controlling every time you move or speak or whatever, amen, that's not a good thing. That can be a very horrible thing. Sometimes you need to be realistic with yourself and ask yourself, who am I? What am I? Where am I headed? Because again, I get it. And even after you get married, understand that my wife is my wife. I get that. She gets that. She understands that. And yet at the same time, though, she's still very much an individual that God created and birthed a dream and a vision and a purpose for her life. And she's to pursue that whether she's my wife or not. Somebody says, oh, no, I have to get married. That all changes. Show me. Show me where that changes. Somebody says, well, the two become one. That's right. The two become one. But yet at the same time, he doesn't take away visions. He don't take away dreams. He don't take away things that you're to pursue for the things of God. The two of you together become one in him, and he ends up causing both of you, amen, literally to complete one another. Are you hearing me? And when that starts going on, when that happens, you got to realize that, again, there's a reason that God gives to you who he gives to you, and that is to complete what God wants you to pursue or the desires that he's placed in your life. Now, every one of us lives with tendencies and desires and strong inclinations that our flesh just naturally lean toward. Some of us, it's just a natural thing. Sometimes we lean toward things because the family has always leaned that way. Some of us go after stuff because we've always been told, well, that's what you ought to go after. But the greatest day in your life is when you decide and you know and you accept what God is birthing in your heart, speaking into your mind and helping you to realize those things are good and I can give you that. But if you'll pursue me, if you will delight yourself in the Lord your God, I'll show you desires that will blow your mind. And he said, that's why I desire to give to you the desires of your heart. He goes on to make the statement, and notice, if you will, all the way through the Word of God, God wants you to do great things, and by themselves, many of these desires are not wrong, neither are they sinful. Even the desires for feeling strong emotions and expressing them is not sinful in its own way. Sometimes God will birth somebody into your spirit, somebody into your heart. You will pray for them. You'll put them on your prayer chain. You will put them on your prayer list. You will do your best to go out of your way to do your best to win them over to the Lord, because God has birthed that individual. And we used to sing an old song, "Lord, lay some soul upon my heart and love that soul through me." How many knows that we need more of that in the day and time that we're living in? We need to be praying for our families. We need to be praying for those we work with. We need to be praying for those we've never, ever met. And yet when God sends us across their path, we need to pray with them and minister in their behalf, because God, hey, you didn't meet them by accident. I know you think you did. I know you assume you did, but even when I go on vacation, I know that when I go on vacation, I'm going to run across somebody's path that the Lord has set them up and set me up so that I can minister to them, say some good words to them, maybe even pray over them or lead them to Christ. God has a way of doing it, because again, if my delight is in the Lord, then He's going to, again, what did He say? I'm going to ordain your footsteps. In other words, I know where you're going, even on your vacation. I'm gonna clear your path and make your way straight, and I'm gonna make things happen in your life, not by accident, but for an eternal reason and purpose. All the way through, God is ministering to our lives, telling us what we need to do and how we need to go about doing it. Here, desires don't make us sinners. Desires make us human. Look at somebody and say, "I don't know if you know it, but I'm very human." All right. Peter was not even suggesting that we should no longer have desires. He is saying that as Christ's disciples, this is in another place where Peter was talking about this, and I'm not going to get into those scriptures today, but Peter was talking about, again, he is saying that as Christ's disciples, your desires should no longer have you, but you should have them. Are you hearing me? Don't let your desires overpower you. You are to overpower your desires. Put them in the right place for the right time and for the right reason. And that's why God starts opening doors for you and allowing you to go into things that you've never been in any day of your life. Maybe only as in a bucket list you thought, and yet God said, "Oh no, it wasn't a bucket list. I planned this for you a long time ago." God has a way of making things happen that you had no idea. Isn't it amazing that God knows more than you do? I know it's hard to believe, but He does. Paul said it like this in 1 Corinthians 6:12. I want you to run over with me, if you will. 1 Corinthians 6:12. I jumped there to Galatians, not there yet. All right, 1 Corinthians 6:12. Notice what it says. "All things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any." Now, I want you to notice something, what he's saying there, really. Everything is permissible for me, but not everything is beneficial. Are you hearing me? Just because you can do it don't mean it's always the right thing for you to go and do. I can get on a bucking bronco. I have. It did not turn out well. So even though it's permissible, it don't mean it's the smartest thing in the world I've ever done. Anybody out there ever thought you ought to do something, and when you did it afterwards, you wished you had never done it? Okay, so you understand what I'm talking about, all right? And here, that's what, boy, could I go places with that. And so Paul understands, everything is permissible for me, but not everything is beneficial. Everything is permissible for me, but I will not be mastered by anything. In other words, what he's saying is, again, I refuse to let anything, anyone, any place, at any time master my life, because I have only one master and I answer to Him and I let Him direct my life. That's what I'm going after, what He wants, because that's all that matters. This is the way of saying that the only controlling power in our life should be the power of the Holy Ghost. Because it said, I'll endue you with power after that you are filled with the Holy Ghost, and I will direct your path in all you go to do. Notice something else. He says, our desires, in other words, can make literally fine servants. They always make horrible masters. I'm going to say it again. Our desires can make fine servants, but they make horrible masters. Don't let anything that you're going after, trying to get a hold of, become just the desire of your heart and become the focus or the focal point. There we go. On what you're trying to do with your life, make sure whatever you do with your life, it is ordained by God. Make sure whoever you mix your company with is mixed with the hand of God. Make sure wherever he ends up sending you, even though you don't think you got the power to do what he tells you you can do, you got to believe him and stop trusting just in what you think. He said, I'll give you the desires of your heart. You know what? Here, when the Lord ends up giving us desires, it's amazing the things that he carries out and the things that he does. I want to read another verse of scripture to you real quick here, if I may. Go with me to Galatians chapter number 5, verse number 17. For the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary, the one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you would. Let me tell you something. When it comes to the things of God, God's going to direct your spirit to do things. And yet your flesh is going to fight against that because that's what our flesh does. Often your flesh will tell you what you can't do, can't become, can't accomplish. You know the list. And yet the Spirit of God will speak into you and say, oh, you're right, you can't. But through Christ, all things are possible to them that believe. And even as you start going forward in the Lord, even as you step out in your faith, even as you do what other people say, well, you ain't got the power to do that. You're right. I may not have the power to do it, but God gives me the power to do it. Somebody may say, well, nobody's give you permission to go do certain things. You're right. Maybe nobody will ever give me permission to do certain things, but if God says I can go do it, I'm going to go do it. There's people that have come and said, hey, you can't go in there. You don't have the right credentials. And yet at the same time, God opened the door without the credentials, let me go in anyway. And then after I got in, they gave me the credentials to prove it. Oh, I'm stating back to you. Even to a point that when the Lord ends up wanting you to do certain things, don't ever doubt he don't have the power, divine authority to get you where he wants you. Matter of fact, he said, hey, when the day comes and I bring you before kings and priests, don't even worry about what you're going to say when you're brought before them. I will fill your mouth. Paul was getting ready to go, and he was going one direction, and yet God spoke to Paul and said, no, Paul, I'm going to send you somewhere else because you got to testify to certain people, and you got to minister to them, and I'm going to bring you right to their doorstep, right into their office, right before their royal desk, and you're going to minister to them whether they want to hear you or not. Amen. Guess what? He did. They listened. Matter of fact, even to the point that some of them had the opportunity for salvation, but they rejected it. One man even made the statement, almost thou persuadest me to become a Christian. I would to God that all the people that have almost been persuaded would have been persuaded, because I guarantee you those that have already died and gone and stood before a holy God wishes they would have changed that step and would have went ahead and accepted him. How many knows that again, folks? If there's ever a time we ever witness, it's now. If there's ever a time we've ever been a child of God, it better be now. The thing that he told us not too many weeks ago, he said, what I have done for you, I have done in a miraculous way. I'm giving to you an opportunity. What will you do with it? How many knows that we've got a great opportunity in front of us, and if we've ever been children of God, if we've ever stood the test of time, if we've ever been bold enough to speak what the word declares, it better be now. We can't lay back. We've we've got to go forward. How many knows it again? He said, I'm raising up my remnant. I'm raising up my warriors. I'm raising up my princess warriors for such a time as this. And ladies and gentlemen, he's opened the door. We got to march through it. We got to be who God called us to be. And we got to realize that he said, hey, I'll give you the desires of your heart. Delight in me. Trust in me. Look to me, because I'm going to give you the desires of your heart, the things you never thought possible by the hand of God. I'm going to do, not just in your home, not just in your life, but in the city that you live in the place where you work, in the place wherever you go. I've got the power to send my anointing, and it will accomplish way more than you ever thought possible. I'm going to do a new thing. Will you not know it? I want to be a part of that new thing. Amen. That's why I refuse to listen to let anything or anybody, I don't let just anything or anybody speak over my life. Mm-mm. No, 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 no. If it don't line up with the word of Almighty God, it's out the door. Amen. Somebody says, oh, well, you better be careful. I am. That's why it's out the door. Yeah. Amen. Obey what the Lord speaks into your spirit. Understand that God is for you, not against you. Amen. Are you hearing me? God is for you, not against you. Here not too long ago, we ended up sending some people overseas. We got people overseas right now. And yet at the same time, God's doing amazing stuff and new works all the time. And good old Radiant Life is being a part of all that. He has opened up recently a great door that he's opened up for us in Armenia. And in Armenia, again, RL Missions International, we were able to get to step through that door with one child. We were able to step through that door again with a number of other people that and organizations that have come along board with that. And there's so many different things that God's allowed us to do. In Armenia, there is a place there in Armenia. Matter of fact, one of the first churches ever built, the first church ever built in the European countries was in Armenia. And in Armenia, again, God has opened such a door there that, again, that there are more Christians starting to come around in Armenia than anywhere else. And he's opened it up to where, again, we basically have become a city of refuge for them. We have become a household for them. And we are starting with the children themselves, even to the point that, again, that we've ended up opening up, I'm going to call it the House of Hope. And the way that this thing all generates, the way this thing goes, is they already are preparing a building. We've already got the building, already working on the rooms and everything that goes with it. And there are going to be at least 50 children automatically that are going to have a safe haven, a place to go where they're taught the word of God, fed good food, dressed in good clothing, and the list goes on and on. And yet at the same time, when God opened up the door for us and allowed us to step through that open door, we took advantage, because how many knows when he does a thing, you got to move on it now. And what God is getting ready to do in the future, amen, through good old Radiant Life Church and what he's even doing right now, is just an understatement of the fact that God will give to us the desires of our heart as long as we pursue him. Are you hearing me, church? As long as we pursue him, as long as we're looking to him and delight in the Lord. Will you stand all over the building? Every head bowed, every eye closed, no one looking around for just a moment. In the process of God's timing, in the process of him looking at our heart, what are your desires? What do you hope for? What is it that you see yourself doing in him? What is it that you see yourself accomplishing for the cause of Christ? And yet in the process of all of it, allow God to cause you to dream bigger. Allow God to help you to reach out more and trust in him greater than you ever have before. Because I believe that God is getting ready to maybe even change some of the desires you've had and birth in you new desires for what's about to become. I believe that in my heart. I believe that with everything within me. There's so much more of God. God's as big as you allow him to be in your life. God's as big as you allow him to be in your life. And you let me tell you, I serve a great big God. I serve a great big God. If you're here today and you know in your heart that there are things, there are desires in your heart, and you know you didn't place them there, but you know God placed them there. And you know that it's important. It's literally mandated by heaven that you carry those out, that you do what God's placed in your heart. That desire is not just some wimpish dream you came up with, but you know that, again, it was ordained by God, and it was God that placed it in your being. If you know that and you're going to go after those desires with everything you got with the help of God Almighty, I want you to step out from where you are and come forward, and doing so, saying, hey, I receive whatever He's planned for the remainder of my life. I receive whatever and wherever He's taken me in my ministry. I receive what it is that God desires to do through my life and my family, and we're going to pursue Him like we've never pursued after Him before. God is going to give to you the desires of your heart. I really wonder what those desires are. He knows, and He can accomplish it. He can make it happen. And I'm believing it. I'm believing it. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, You know our heart desire more than anything else. God, You know the things that You've placed in us and the things that are being birthed through us. Lord, I pray today, God, that You continually move and minister. Lord, thank You for opening up supernatural doors. Thank You, God, for allowing us to come forward, Lord, and not only to plant seed in such a strategic area, but God, also to see things already moving in that behalf. Lord, I praise You today, and I worship You in spirit and in truth. Thank You, Lord, again, for the connections that You've given us with Doc, with Ty, God, again, with Wolf, and all the others that are involved. Lord, I thank You, Lord, for everything that You are accomplishing by Your mighty hand in the day and time that we live in. Lord, I praise You. I'm going to go after my desires. I'm going to go after what You've planted in my heart. And I'm going to fulfill the call of God on my life. My delight is in my God. And I praise You today. Sing it to the Lord today. Oh, yes.
Washed in His blood.
Oh, blessed Jesus.
And what He did for me on Calvary is more than enough.
Oh, more than enough.
I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail.
He'll never fail.
Submission.
Oh, yes.
Uh-huh. All is at rest. I know the author of tomorrow has ordered my steps.
Oh, You've ordered my steps. Hallelujah.
This is my story.
This is my story.
This is my song.
Hallelujah.
Praising my risen King and Savior.
Give the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords a good hand clap of praise today. Bless His wonderful, wonderful, wonderful name. Amen. Amen. Never, never, never give up on the desires of your heart. It's the Lord that places them there. And then when you get those desires, you go after them. Amen. You, your family, and those things that God has birthed in you. There's a divine purpose and reason behind it. And the fun part is finding out what that is. Amen. I want you to shake hands with two or three people around you and tell them, it's been good to be in church with you today. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. You are dismissed. Bless you.